Hey, welcome to Between Two Counters, episode 2. So today we're going to talk about programming. We're going to discuss some of our aims, how we modify things, and then the balance between training for fun and then the competing aspect of it. So, Colm, what is our main aim here at CrossFit Ireland for our programming for our athletes and our members?
Okay, so, you know, it's always a tricky thing to talk about CrossFit programming, but the aim is to make you excellent at everything. So we don't want to just be strong or just be able to run or just be able to, you know, do gymnastics. You want to be good at everything. You want to pick up twice your body weight, but also have the resilience to pick up it 40 times or 50 times. You want to be able to do your push-ups, your sit-ups, your ring rows, right the way up to do a handstand climb or rope eventually. And then couple all that with the likes of jumping up on boxes, row, run, skip, burpee, swing a kettlebell. And I suppose the aim behind that is, like, number one is it stops you getting boring. It's not the same thing every day. Yeah. Second to that, then, is that your body adapts to fitness really quickly. So, like, if you just go out for a run 2-3 times a week and it's always about 25 minutes around the park.
Very monotonous, yeah.
Yeah, your body gets really used to that. Like, within 4 sessions, it's got most of the benefit. So, at that point, then, you know, you're not losing any body fat. You're not gaining any lung capacity, building any muscle. Whereas, if you went out one day and did 100 meter sprints, and then the next day you did 10K, and then the next day you went 3K up and down hills, and one day you're on a track, one day you're on a trail, one day you're on a treadmill, your body would have to get used to all types of running, and then we've tried to expand that out to all types of fitness, you know? So that's the general aim of CrossFit. Mm-hmm. Then in here, we want to program for your fitness, your health, and your happiness. And working backwards, the happiness comes from, like, giving your best effort, knowing that that's enough. And, you know, when you push yourself, you feel a lot better than if you just come in and go through the motions. So that's kind of the simple thing, you know? And you also want to have a supportive environment, a bit of crack, love some people chilling on the couch afterwards, yeah. Maybe taking them 20, 30 minutes to get the breath back. That's good. The health aspect is all our warm-up stuff, the amount of time we put into people's joints, because, you know, everyone wants to build muscle and drop fat. You know, they want to look better and perform better.
But so you're saying there, just that on your warm-ups, you're saying that people don't just come in, have a little brisk kind of 400-meter run, and then they're straight into the workout, like flat out? We don't do that here?
No.
What kind of aspect do we do on
your
warm-ups here?
So, then? I mean, we call it a warm-up because everyone understands it, but I mean, a more technical term is joint strengthening and joint health. So. You're stressing the joints, like joints get 1/10 blood flow of muscles. So you're stressing them in a way, you're building them beyond the range of motion. So instead of squatting just below parallel, we're gonna squat right to the range, and then we're gonna go side to side. Because in here, yeah, you're gonna squat up and down nice and straight, but you're out playing rugby and you go to twist and turn, your knee needs to be able to have that surplus of energy or surplus of range of motion and strength. So that's a big thing with the health, is getting that done, you know?
So we're really prepping the joints efficiently, getting them mobile and supple so they can essentially do more work without injuries becoming more frequent.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're not just throwing people in the deep end here saying, okay, let's do Fran.
Yes.
With a 5-minute warm-up, we take our time.
Yeah, absolutely. Because, you know, we're lucky that we're on our feet for most of the day. Most people are commuting, long commutes, long time at work, they're getting tight. And, you know, stretching isn't that intrinsically exciting, but a couple of bear crawls, a couple of half-kneeling presses, you're actually getting stronger in that. That's the health aspect of that. And then, you know, because we're in the positive environment, the social health helps, that, you know, this is your fun place, you know. Mm-hmm. You're going to be the best version of yourself here as well, and that's, you know, it's good for your self-esteem. And, oh man, I never thought I'd put the green plates or the blue plates in the bar, and we're picking it up.
Yeah.
And then the fitness aspect is we judge it by the CrossFit Open. So we want everyone to come out of the Open going, yeah, I was as well prepared as I could have been. I've got some stuff to work on going forward.
Sweet, that's great. So how do we progress things and modify for our programming for, say, the likes of brand new people who come in, and then you've got your people who are doing it for a year, 2 years, 3 years. How do we progress that in our classes? Because the programming is not individualized, right? It's group programming, group classes, but how do we kind of tweak it and progress it for each individual person? Sam, what do you think?
So it's, I think it kind of is, we all do the same class, so no one's doing something like super different to anyone unless they're coming for the bonus program. Mm-hmm. So everyone does the same thing. So, but there's always the different levels of what you can do. So like say max snatch days, you're not gonna hit everyone's gonna be hitting their own capabilities, you know?
Yeah.
So it's kind of ranges between what you're capable of, but everyone's capable of doing the same thing.
Yeah,
at the different ranges.
Yeah, so when you're talking about barbell movement, it's quite easy to progress because you kind of progress the weight. But give me some examples of, say, some of those higher skill movements, say
muscle ups
or handstand push-ups. How do you progress those? So people are working the same movement pattern, the muscle groups, but it's the movement looks completely different.
So for like a muscle up, you need to take it back. So it's the rings. You start with the rings. So you'd say, okay, first thing you want to be able to do is your false grip. So you hold your false grip on the rings. That'll translate into, well, obviously the muscle up later on, but then you'd be able to do your ring rows. Then you'd kind of put your feet on the box, that kind of thing, and put more weight into your arms, take it off, or like put more tension into the movement, and so forth. And then you can eventually build it up to a muscle up, okay? But it's the kind of the skill and the practice of the long term kind of.
So there's like steps you can be taking. There's progressions for every kind of movement.
Yeah, exactly. So you kind of just look at the movement and, okay, I want to get a muscle up. The first thing is like start with the rings, get the correct positions, and then build the strength.
Yeah, and work from there.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Because I know when people Google CrossFit, they get like Matt Fraser and Catherine Davis.
They see everyone doing all these massively impressive moves, like ring muscle ups, handstand push ups, max snatches, and they're like, they sometimes get overwhelmed, but they're like, where do I.
And everyone can
start.
Do that. And that's one thing I like there. We don't say you can't do that, we don't put barriers in front of your weight. But if you're learning how to do a handstand push-up, great benefits, but you might start doing a push-up with the barbell suspended, so you're really just pushing yourself off the wall and progressing to a push-up, going into a pike position, so you're actually pushing upside down, stepping up on a box, and eventually getting up to a wall. Or some days you're just gonna hold dumbbells and press because it's the same movement pattern.
Yeah.
And
same muscle groups, but in a different kind of capacity.
And I think that's cool that we have like Sam here. He's like a regional qualified athlete. And he's the type of person you do see on YouTube. You've got him training alongside someone who's like coming in for class one, and it's the same similar movement. There's a squat, there's a pull.
Yeah.
Sam might be doing it a certain way,
So the muscle groups and the movement pattern is essentially the same, but the intensity, capacity, load is what we can vary when we want people from beginners to more advanced. But everyone's going to, so say for example, you've got a squatting day, you've got pull-ups or whatever, everyone's going to work that same movement pattern and build strength and efficiency in that movement, but where you are in the spectrum on that skill will vary from individual to individual. Sweet. So one more thing I wanted to talk about was how do we kind of separate the kind of having fun in the classes and in the gym and then kind of going to more kind of competing and training really, really hard. So because we have Sam here, for example, he's qualified for regionals this year, but Sam trains alongside some of our beginners, like you said, and we need to kind of separate the kind of, you're training for fun and health and happiness, and maybe you want to take it a little more serious. Like, how do we kind of manage that in here for our members and stuff?
I think for the difference between training seriously and training fun, I think there actually shouldn't be a difference. So I think if you're training seriously enough, you'd obviously find it fun.
Yeah.
You wouldn't be committed so much that if you weren't enjoying it. So, and I don't like hearing people say, I hope double-unders don't come up, or hope this does come up and this doesn't do it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
In the open, in competition, I was like, well, it is all in the bracket of CrossFit. You signed up for CrossFit as a whole. You didn't sign up to the open to do CrossFit minus double-unders. You signed up for everything. You kind of have to, not, I wouldn't say learn to enjoy everything, but your mindset should kind of involve or entail that it's all CrossFit and it's all benefiting you and it's all something you need to practice and I don't think there should be a separation of having fun versus serious training. I think your serious training should be fun. And then again, the class itself is super fun, It's not, there's no not fun days.
Absolutely.
Oh, Thursday. That's a not fun day.
It doesn't exist.
Yeah, exactly.
Speaking of, we do, once a week, every Thursday, so right before this podcast, is we look at the week and we say, right, what lessons did we learn?
Mm-hmm.
What do people need? And
this is at the coaching staff as a whole.
And there's always that balance point between, enjoying the workout and pushing yourself into that like uncomfortable phase where, you are going to be humbled. When you're starting off, you kind of think, okay, cool, in a month or two, I'll know all the movements. And we're all years in the sport. We're like, okay, well, I need to get better at this.
There's always something to kind of improve
on. And even to take like a specialty sport like yours, you know, it's two movements, but you still refine and enjoying that process of getting better and getting small wins. I mean, when you start off, you look at a barbell and you get stronger.
Mm-hmm.
And ultimately, it's like, oh, okay, I need to maybe hop on the GHD once a week and strengthen my hamstrings. You know, or I need to do extra pull-up work, or I'll do some ring rows and curls 10 minutes after class. But I like what Sam says, like, you can't compete if it's not fun. You know, you can't go, but I want to enter this competition, but I really hope that thing I don't want to happen happens.
Yes, yeah, mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Yeah.
All right, guys, great. So that's kind of an overview of our program, our aims, our purpose behind it, how we kind of progress things for our athletes, and then the idea of how your training should be enjoyable, but you still should have some guidelines and some focus on an idea where you're going to go in relation to progressing and improving your overall fitness, health, and happiness, and that's what we're trying to do here. So any final points, guys, you want to make before we wrap up our second episode of Between Two Couches?
Oh, I hope people have listened this far for a start.
Hopefully, yeah.
I think it's cool. Like, I mean, that's our aim for you guys, fitness, health, and happiness. And some people, this is just stress relief. They come in, they switch off, we tell them what to do, and they're happy with that. Some people really want to improve in the sport. Some people want to use this to get in shape. And that's cool that, you know, we've created something that allows high-level athletes to push themselves, but also allows people to use this as just a switch off.
Yeah.
You know, and it's something we're always refining. But allows people to fit wherever they want in the spectrum. Maybe they want us to give them more advice on stuff outside of here, like nutrition and sleep and stress management.
Yeah.
Maybe they just want to go, okay, I'm coming here to work out fully, and maybe it's just they're just here to have a laugh and sweat. And you can do all three of those things,
yeah.
I think. And that's
we offer everything. We offer everything. Yes, I mean it's those three points.
Yeah.
Fitness, health and happiness.
Yeah.
Social aspect, health aspect, and getting a break from the chaos of real life sometimes helps for people for an hour. Alright, that's from us. Team CFI, thanks for tuning in. Bye.